Daniel here to show how to color tracks automatically based on the track name in Cubase. The benefit of doing this is centered on productivity and improved visual organization. Now, this is only made possible via a macro that executes several Project Logical Editor presets one by one. I've decided to upload the macro and PLE presets in a zip file where you can download the content for free. This has been tested only on Windows but should work on macOS. So we want to open a web browser. I'll open up Google Chrome and go to shop.danielio.com. Just want to click on autocolor tracks. Click buy now. Enter your email address. Click continue. Click download now. Click download again. Let's open the location and click the extract all. Show extracted files when complete. Have that ticked. Click extract and that will unzip the file. To import the presets, open the parent folder and click on the Project Logical Editor. And we want to right click and copy the DA color folder and go into documents, Steinberg, Cubase, user presets, the Project Logical Editor window, and just paste. If we go back to downloads, let's open the file. In order to import the key commands file with the macro, we want to go to the key commands folder and copy the DA color key commands XML file. And this time, to make it a little easier, if you click on the address bar within the file explorer and type % user profile % /app data, press enter. From then just click on roaming Steinberg and then pick the version of Cubase. I'm gonna go with Cubase 13. Go to presets, key commands, and then control V to paste the DA color key command, and then I can close the window. So with Cubase open, go to edit key commands, because we'll need to import the macro into our existing key commands. We want to click the select preset box and make sure that if we've made any custom key assignments that we save them as a separate preset first. So I'm gonna select save preset. I'll just call it test, press OK. And then once that's saved, I'll click the select preset box again and now select the DA color key commands. You'll notice that because this uses the default Cubase 13 key command assignments, it's overridden all of my pre-existing customized key commands. Click the select preset box again and click test in this case. And the keys that I have been restored, but I still have access to the auto color tracks macro. If I close the key commands window and execute the macro using the key command, Alt and the hash key, we get instant color coding on the tracks that describe the instrument name. So it's important to name your tracks appropriately in order to get the most out of this macro. So we can see bass is red, I've made kick orange, crash tambourine, clap yellow as follows. In order to actually know what name will trigger a color change, we need to have a look behind the curtain on the PLE presets. Let's go to Project, Project Logical Editor, Setup, and then we go to the preset box and go to User Presets, DA Color, and then we can pick drums, for example, where I've added different drum names to trigger the desired color, which is orange based on color 2. Now, the reasoning behind my particular choice is just related to the frequency range of each instrument section, starting with the lowest bass and then going up the color spectrum. But the color can be changed, and if you want to add names or remove names, you can do so to your heart's content just by selecting insert, ensuring that the bool is set to all, change the filter target to name, condition to contains, and maybe another type of drum. So there you have it, a breakdown on how to color code tracks automatically in Cubase. Like, comment, and share if this has been helpful. Take care.